Closer, please. I've something to tell you. Ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? This is Black Sabbath. You are about to see three tales of terror and the supernatural. I do hope you haven't come alone. As you will see from one of our tales, vampires, Verdilax, are bound everywhere. Is that one sitting behind you now? You can't be too careful, you know. They look perfectly normal, and indeed they are. Except they only drink the blood of those whom they love the best. Ah. There I go talking shop again. Let's get on with our first tale. Psst. Psst. Do you believe in ghosts? You don't? Well, now, you must admit that there are things that frighten us. You can't deny that there are signs from the dead. In this tale by Chekhov, The Drop of Water, we prove that a ghost doesn't have to be seen to be believed.
Hello? 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 Hello, yes, good evening. You mean go there right away? But I can't, it's late. But wouldn't tomorrow morning do just as well, very early, let's say? Calm down, calm yourself. Yes, yes, but I still don't think it's necessary. Yes, very well. Well, yes, yes, I'll come. But please, please, for heaven's sakes, give me time to get there. What a fool.
is it?
It's me. Open the door.
Oh, miss, what a long time it took you to come here.
But I thought it was fast. I got here as fast as I could.
I had to call in someone professional like you, nurse. Believe me, I tried to manage it. I simply couldn't do it. Only you can help me. You're used to it.
Yes, fine idea you had.
Shh.
With this awful storm and everything. Well, take me to her.
I just have to warn you first. You must not touch any of my mistress's things when you get in there. She told me there'd be a terrible curse on anyone who did. That they would die a horrible death. I believe her. She had such strange powers as a medium.
Aren't you at least going to come and help me?
No, no, I'm sorry, miss. You'll have to do it by yourself. It's too much for me. Poor Madame Zina. I haven't touched her. She's just as the doctor left her.
So I see. Have you at least prepared the dress that she's to wear?
Oh, yes, indeed. I've just finished ironing it. Come, come. Died all alone. Not one friend was at her bedside. Oh, oh my, this lamp. No friend, no loved one. No one at all.
Why not?
They're afraid, that's why. Afraid.
Afraid of what?
Oh, everybody says that spirits of the dead killed her. The ghosts.
Foolishness.
Oh, I wouldn't say so, Miss Dorrit. It's easy to talk. The way she died.
But it was a heart attack. I should know. I kept her going with camphor injections. Well, besides, the doctor said so, too.
I know, but that doesn't mean anything. The fact is she died during one of those spiritual seances. While she was in a trance, you understand? In a trance. Talking with the dead was a regular obsession with her. Poor thing. Every Friday, no matter what. Every Friday.
And with a heart as delicate as hers. Talking with the dead. What nonsense. Let's get started. Stockings, too.
Right away.
Are you going to stay here tonight?
Oh, certainly not. I'm going to leave with you.
But who's going to stay, then?
Oh, you'll need shoes, too. It's no longer my concern who stays and who doesn't. I come back tomorrow morning when the undertakers have closed the coffin, and that's all I know.
Did you find them?
Not yet. I'm looking for the good shoes. Oh, they must be around here someplace.
It's nothing. Nothing at all.
I found them at last, and they're nearly new.
Here, let me have them.
in there.
Upstairs, and then you opened the door?
Yes, but I was not alone, sir. The neighbors were on the landing. We tried pushing the door, but it was locked on the inside. We finally managed to ram it open with our shoulders. She was already like that, so I made everybody leave. No one touched a thing here. I know. I know what to do in such a case like this. I immediately called the police.
Evidently, she was about to go to bed.
This could have been from a ring being pulled from her finger. Must have been in a hurry. It's the only bruise on her. Strange case. No sign of violence, yet she looks completely contorted in fear. Almost as if she'd been frightened to death. As if she'd seen something too horrible to live through.
Say all we like about ghosts, but we still don't really know how or where they may appear. Yes, 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 I know all about that. In the old days, they used to drag their chains through the icy corridors of castles or stalk through the musty rooms of deserted houses. But now, you never know where you'll find one of the terrible things. As you will see from our next story, The Telephone.
Hello.
Hello, Rosie. How are you?
Who is this speaking? Who?
Don't you know? Think, Rosie. How nice you look with that towel around you. You always did have a beautiful body. Beautiful. A body to drive someone crazy. No, don't cover yourself. I like seeing you this way. Are you listening, Rosie?
But who are you? Hello. Hello. What do you want of me?
Everything. Everything that you have. But for now, I just want you to take off that dressing gown. I want to watch you, embrace you with my eyes, see you.
Who are you? Who are you? Tell me. I can't stand anymore. I can't stand it. What have I done to you? What have I done? You're driving me mad. Please tell me.
Betty. What are you barking for? There's nobody here. What's the matter?
Good evening, Colonel. Excuse me.
But you're frightened. What happened? You look upset.
No, no, it's nothing. I assure you, it's absolutely nothing.
You're safe with me. You can tell me about it. Come on.
I was just frightened by nothing at all. Frank is dead. This can't be Frank.
Hello?
Mary, this is Rosie.
Oh, what happened? Whatever made you call me, of all people?
Mary, it's important. Frank just called me.
What are you talking about? You worry me. You know as well as I do he's dead.
No, he's alive.
Take it easy.
Oh, Mary, Mary, I'm afraid. He wants to get even. I know he does. Come over here, right away, please.
What? He spoke to you? Did I hear you right?
Yes, yes, I beg you. Come right away. He's been threatening me.
All right, I'm coming. I don't have any hard feelings. I will be over right away.
Thanks. Hurry.
Go ahead, Rosie. Take your time. Let's hear the story.
I can barely talk about it. It's so awful.
You say he threatened you? How could he?
I tell you, he's alive. I know it was him I heard on the telephone. He spoke in a nightmarish voice, and he said such frightening things to me. He knows everything I do, move by move. Even when I took off my dress and was wearing a dressing gown. How is it possible, Mary? He died 3 months ago. We both knew about the same time. Sorry, Mary. Sorry for what happened. I never meant to hurt you, but you must help me now. You can't imagine how he sounded. It was terrifying. He's after me.
Frank is dead. You're distraught. Imagining things.
He's alive, I tell you. Why, he knows I called you. He called me right afterwards.
Don't think about it. Listen to me. What you need is to go to bed and relax.
He said I would die before dawn.
Probably a crank call. And if it were him, why would he want to kill you?
Mary, I was the one who turned him in, and he knew it. I'm scared.
You're all right. I'm here now. And tomorrow we'll go together to the police. Now, no one can call you. Get me a nightgown now, and I'll go make us something to drink. From Frank. It's a tranquilizer. There. You drink this and you won't feel a thing. In your tea, not only because you needed it, but also because it would give me the opportunity to consult a psychiatrist about your disturbed state of mind before you could awake. These hallucinations about Frank's being alive, talking to you, threatening your life, are obviously signs that you need help.
Thank you.
Now a few words about vampires. Usually they live in Central Europe. Some people say they only leave their coffins at night, and they cannot see themselves in mirrors. Some people deny all these things. But everyone agrees on one thing. They live on blood. This, then, from a novel by Ivan Tolstoy, is the story of the Verdelaks, vampires who live only on the blood of those they love.
Where did you find that dagger?
Do you always give strangers in this house such a warm welcome?
Who are you?
Count Vladimir Dufay, on my way to Yassi.
That dagger. It's my father's. Give it to me.
Here.
You found it nearby?
Come, I'll show you. There was a body on that horse there.
If you killed this bandit, may God reward you for it.
It's Alibek.
It has to be. No one else in the whole region wears clothes like this.
Who was this Alibek?
A Turkish bandit, Count. Terrible. He's cut the throat of many a man.
They say he was a Vertilak.
When he found him, he had this in his back.
Thank you.
Last week he killed our fourth shepherd. Father got so angered he decided not to stay quiet any longer. He'd put an end to Alibek. He would go after him.
My brother and I insisted on going with him, naturally. But he wouldn't let us. A stubborn man. He never lets anyone question his decisions.
Oh, thank you. What is your name?
Zdenya.
It's a strange name. I don't think I've ever heard it before. Well, at any rate, your father found Alibek and did put a finish to it. I think we should drink to that.
Yes. Alibek is dead. Now, we only have our father to fear.
I don't understand. Alibek is dead. Your fears are over. You should all be happy.
If he has not returned within an hour, it'll be better for you to leave this house. To remain here, even for one night, could be fatal for you.
Why didn't you take my brother's advice?
Oh, you could say because I was too tired to travel on tonight. Or your brother's remark made me curious. But that wouldn't be true. The real reason is because I met you.
You are very kind, my lord. But if my father should return after 10 o'clock, it'd be unpleasant for you, my lord. I beg of you, please go.
What your father does every night after 10 o'clock must be very interesting. To terrorize an entire household like this.
Please, you mustn't joke about it.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
The situation's extremely grave.
Can you tell me what it is?
Stanya, please, I would like to help you. Confide in me.
My father said before he went away, I'll be back within 5 days. If, however, I should return after the 5th day, you must not let me in. You must kill me and drive a lance through my heart. Because by then I shall have become a Verdelac.
Verdelac? I've already heard your brother use that word, but I don't understand what it means.
Even if anyone pronounces the word, something in us trembles in terrible horror. A Verdelac is a corpse. It's a cadaver always seeking blood, the blood of the living. So now you know, my lord.
And when do the 5 days end?
10 o'clock. If it's only 1 second after, it's too late.
Clock has already struck.
God help us.
How can we be sure?
Why don't you move to meet me? I'm wounded. Why don't you say something? Ah. 5 days spent in the mountains changed me so much. Even my own dog doesn't know me.
Did you hear? He admits that 5 days are past.
Show me your wound. I'll bind it up.
Go away. You hurt me.
Then you have been wounded in the heart?
I am hungry. Are you going to stay here long?
No, tonight only. I have to be off to Yassi.
Now, then tell everyone you meet that the bandit Ali Beck was killed by old Gorka.
Indeed, I will.
A great feat, Father. Tell us how you did it.
He's dead. That's all there is to it. There's nothing to tell. What is that?
Roast lamb.
Rubbish! I'm not hungry. The cold that is freezing my bones is choking me. Tell that damned dog to stop his howling. I told you to shut him up. Do I give an order twice? Do as I say.
But it's your favorite dog.
Kill him. Kill him. What's the matter, woman? Can't I fondle my own grandson? Give him to me.
Father, it's late. The boy is sleepy.
Give Grandfather a big kiss.
You know, sir, it was I who found the body of Ali Beck.
How can you be sure that it was really Ali Beck?
Of course it was, Father. His clothes, his jewels, and also your dagger.
My dagger? You think my dagger and a headless corpse are proof enough? Right now, in this district, people will believe that he is alive and be ready to tremble with fear again. I and I alone have the proof that Ali Beck is dead. Ah, and here it is.
That's why the dog was howling. He can smell the dead man's head.
Hang it on the door of the house for all to see.
Now, don't worry. Go to sleep. You too, Miss Napier. Go to bed. I will stand guard for him.
It's not necessary. I'm sure he's only wounded.
I'm not so sure. You saw it, didn't you? He refused to eat anything.
Let Peter stand guard. It's been too many nights now that you haven't slept.
She's right. You stay with him.
I'll be quiet going to bed.
present for you.
I'm sorry if I frightened you.
You're going. What will happen to me? What's going to happen to me? Peter is dead. Yvonne is gone. My father. It's like a nightmare. A terrible nightmare. I want to wake up. And I can't. I can't.
Zdenya, listen to me. As long as you remain in this house, your nightmare will never end. Zdenya, come away with me. Escape with me.
No. I can't.
Don't you understand that it's crazy to stay here? To live in terror and die inside. You mustn't destroy yourself like this. Zdenya, come away with me now.
I have no alternative.
Yes, you have. You have the alternative of being free, of being happy. Of falling in love.
Love. Happiness. They're not for me anymore.
Oh, no. You've only got to want them, Zdenya. We've only got to want them together because... I love you. Perhaps when you're away from here, from this nightmare, you could also love me.
For his soul's peace. I did it for Peter, too.
No, not to him. If you do it, I will kill myself.
What's the matter?
Nothing. It's the wind. Don't listen. For the love of God, don't listen to him.
It's my child. Can't you hear? He's cold.
Please, Maria, don't. You buried him. Can't you understand? You buried him yourself. He's dead, Maria.
Let me go to him. Let me go. He needs me. He's cold.
But that's not your child out there. It's the Verdelac.
I don't care. I don't care. Let me go.
Safe in here.
I think I found a bed for you. It may not be the most comfortable you've ever had, but it will serve you very well. Zdenia, what's the matter?
Nothing.
Now you must forget it. You can't go on like this or you'll be running away from yourself forever.
Oh, Vladimir. Please. Don't you understand?
Only thing I understand is that I love you. And if you let this thing hang over your head, you'll ruin your life. And mine.
No. No. Please.
Stanya, forgive me. Don't cry. Stanya.
Why did you leave us?
I beg you. Where are you? I beg you. I beg you, have pity on me. I can't help it, Father. You don't know how much it pains me. But I had to leave. He loves me.
No one can love you as much as we do. You know that. You mustn't be afraid of anything.
Why did you leave us?
Why did you leave us? Why did you leave us? Why did you leave us?
Why did you leave us? Why did you leave us? Why did you leave us?
Why?
Denya! Denya!
Denya.
I wanted to be yours. I love you. I wanted to be yours, and I couldn't.
But why did you leave me? Why did you come back here?
They knew we were going to Yasi. I know them. They would have killed you. Forget this. Forget everything and escape. I'll remain here for now on.
Escape? No. No. I would rather die than lose you.
Oh, embrace me, Vladimir. I want you, my dearest, forever. Embrace me and blend your kisses with mine. Kiss me now. Embrace me.